আসসালামু আলাইকুম, আপনারা সবাইকে আবারও স্বাগত জানাচ্ছি। উই ওয়ার টকিং অ্যাবাউট আর্ট অ্যান্ড কালচার। আপনারা সবাই ফোন করতে পারেন, আমাদের সাথে কথা বলতে পারেন, আপনাদের ভিউগুলা তুলে ধরতে পারেন। ইফ দেয়ার ইজ এনি ব্রাদার্স অর সিস্টার্স দেয়ার আর আর্টিস্ট, প্লিজ কল ইন অ্যান্ড ইন্সপায়ার আস। সো বিফোর উই ওয়েন্ট টু ব্রেক, উই ওয়ার টকিং টু yourself, I don't want to say the name again, I can just say yes.
Okay.
Yes, tell us about your journey through, you know, yeah. I'm sure it's not always rosy, rosy, it's difficult sometimes.
Basically, you know, definitely it started in my childhood.
In the same time, we're going to see some of your work, is that?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So when I was in school, I had a very great passion about art. Besides, you know, studying, I used to have my sketchbook and I used to sketch all the time. Most of the time I used to sketch, and later on I started painting with colors as well. But my father was very negative about it, and as he was very conservative kind of person. And yeah, this is a verse from the Quran. Okay. And this is I basically started learning calligraphy a few months back, so this is one of my calligraphies. This is on canvas with mixed media color, watercolor, and also ink and acrylic colors as well. So I was talking about, you know, my father was very negative and I couldn't continue it. After the matriculation exam, then I went to university, and meanwhile it's a big gap. And then again after my level 10 or year 9 or 10, I started again in 2013 here. So you can say that literally it's been 3 years I'm practicing you know, proper art.
Fantastic. Can I see one of your canvas, art, please?
Sorry? This is basically, I wanted to portray a mosque, and this is the symbol of faith. So you can say it with the expression of colors, because, you know, you see that in the mosque, different colors of people go there, people from different countries, different culture, different color, different norms, they go to the mosque, but mosque unite everyone. So this is the symbol of faith.
Next one.
Oh. Yeah, this is, this is a very typical Bangladeshi boat. And when I was painting this, I was feeling like, you know, I traveled many part of the country, Bangladesh, and I also rode boats as well. So I can remember that when I was painting this one, then I was remembering the struggle of the, you know, fishermen of Bangladesh. You know, the fishermen are such a struggling person and symbol of Bangladeshi, you know, culture and life and everything. So in the river, when they fish, you know, the waves, they come and it's so big, and they struggle to balance themselves. And this is the symbol of that. The boat is symbol of their struggle and life.
What I love about that is you've done what Turner does, and you've caught the movement of the wind. I don't even know how, but you can actually feel the wind
with the colors.
Sails. It's absolutely amazing.
Thank you very much. So yeah, this is you know, for the last 3 years, I have been doing it, and so consistently, and I believe that this is the one thing I'm consistent on. The other things, I studied literature, I did master's in linguistics, and later on I didn't continue anything of that. But the art is one thing I'm continuously practicing, and I believe that I should be very dedicated, whatever happens, but I should be dedicated on continuing my art journey. And I'd love to, you know, enhance it. I'd love to practice more and more to control on the brushes. And nowadays I'm trying to mingle with the calligraphy and my landscape art or abstract art, whatever you say, but I'm trying to make a combination of calligraphy and, you know, my other
arts.
But
you're also a writer. Where do you get the time from? You're writing, you write poems.
Yeah, okay, I need
to
say
about it.
I want
to hear a poem from you.
Writing is another journey. I started in 2004. I clearly remember when I wrote the first poem, and it was about death. Okay, I was feeling death so intensely, and I wrote a poem about death that it was an image on the poem as well. Like I was writing, like I'm dead, and you know, the people in the funeral, they're carrying me.
Can you say the poem?
Yeah, no, I forgot it completely, but I can remember the image. I wrote that I'm dead, I'm the dead body, and people are carrying me, and I'm just slightly moving on the, you know, on the, what can I say, the coffin. Mm. Okay, they're carrying the coffin, I'm inside it, and I'm still moving down and forward like this. And I was trying to portray that what I'm feeling at the time. I was trying to imagine myself. And that was the first poem, and that was published in a magazine, in a little mag. And they paid for the poem to me, and that's a very interesting thing. So yeah, I'm writing. Since then, I was a blogger. I was commenting about the political issues. I was a very active blogger.
We did another show for her.
Exactly. I'm just thinking. Yeah,
so we're going to hear blogging, a poem from you now.
Blogging is,
if it's possible.
Blogging was a great passion, but I stopped doing it later on because, you know, because the regarding the blogs. Lots of things happening in Bangladesh. They are barricading the bloggers not to write about the political issues in Bangladesh. So I stopped it later on, but I'm still writing the poems. And I wrote short stories, but I didn't continue it. I'm writing poems regularly.
Can we have a poem from you now, please?
From me, to be very honest, I forget my poems.
Okay.
But I can try later on. If you just go through this way, then I can
memorize it. Okay.
I can
Hasan bhai, apnar kache jawa khubi joruri ekhon pore geche. Apni to ei line e, you doing a lot of things in that field. How was your journey and what's your future plan?
To be honest, I would not say it's a journey I intend to happen or anything like this. It just happened. If I was to go back to my, I grew up in Bangladesh, and most of my life was spent in Bangladesh. Only a couple of years I'm here. I've done my graduation in Bangladesh as well. So when I was in school, I don't know if you guys ever used this, we used to use fountain pen with ink, not the ballpen, fountain pen. I personally think this is the earliest I can remember when I started this journey. So fountain, bedside of the fountain pen was, when it drops ink, it messes around everything. So every single drop of ink was to go on my paper or my notebook everywhere. I always used to make the use of it. I never let it go like this. I used to make it a shape.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it could be an animal, it could be an object, anything. I never ever, I felt like it's a waste of that drop of ink. I always used to make some shape with it. I think this is where my journey starts. Mm-hmm. And I have to say, my father, he's a good artist. He's really a really good artist. And I think this is something I have got inherently as well. His handwriting is the most beautiful handwriting I've ever seen, my dad. So I think this is where he started.
Hasan, but we're just going to see one of your...
Sure, inshallah.
Look at this.
One, I would, let me explain. This says in Arabic, Fajr. The prayer time, the Fajr, the first prayer we go. And this is where I would like to address to our young viewers here. That's, look, this is a huge potential in this world, and there's a career prospect in here. This, look, behind this word saying Fajr, you can see there's a light coming up, and it is that time. It is that time when Fajr. It's not only just the writing. It's a light coming out from behind that word. Meaning it's that time.
Sun rising.
Exactly, exactly what it is. This reminds me of one more thing as well. I've recently done a cover design for a book, a well-known writer's book. I'm not mentioning the book name or writer at this moment. And when you were saying what are the future of this, you know, I personally believe and strongly believe, for our young viewers who are watching at this moment, I would recommend you to come into this career path. You can take it as a career, believe me. there's a huge world ahead of us to do lots of things. You can combine graphics design with your own art. This is exactly what I've done in here. You can see the background is not done by me, but somebody else, and I've combined all that. In graphics design, you can combine your calligraphy with the graphics motions and all that. It's a big world out there to work on.
And nowadays, you do book designs as well.
Exactly, I've just recently done one, and also, alhamdulillah, you'd be happy to know I've in some TV programs I've written the title names of the programs in calligraphy.
Wow!
So that's been used. So these are the new way of doing things. You know, nowadays you've noticed you know, loads of things are illustrated in you know, if you see YouTube clips and all that, you can be an illustrator. And that's a form of art. It's very, very dynamic and, you know, developing world. So I would request our young brothers, sisters who are watching at this moment, please come forward. Mm-hmm. And as I said at the very beginning, speak your mind out. Whatever you have inside you, just get it out. And, mm-hmm. and you know, believe me, don't ever. If you are in this in the world of art, and if you would like to do some arts, don't ever think of, okay, I'm going to make money off it. Don't do this. Just do it. Just do your best, and believe me, one day you will be recognized. Forget about somebody's recognizing you or not. It's the peace of mind you have. Believe me, some of my artwork, I have to say, mostly done in the middle of the night. I can't sleep. Something bothering me. I just woke up and just do something. That gives me peace. Mm. It feels like, believe me, it might sound
just
crazy,
watching it,
but believe me, that's exactly how I do it. And I never ever call my stuff art, or I'm an artist, never call that. I just do it. Just because I want to do something, it's so much eagerness, so much enthusiasm I have. I just have to do it.
Fantastic.
And then I feel calm.
Nothing will stop you. I miss you.
Inshallah.
Mm. Actually, I know before you know, I was reading Surah Asr. No, Asr actually. You remember Noman Ali Khan?
Yes.
He said Surah Asr, mm. tafsir, and then it was the background was
illustration.
Oh, it was amazing.
That's exactly
what
I mean.
It's the first time
I
understood that,
that
message so clear.
Mm. Exactly.
And now my question to Nahid Bhai is, you know, if our young people or young kids, if they not into these things, we're always going to say good thing about others doing it. What is our activity? What we're doing about it is very important.
It's a good question, Ishaq Bhai. Actually, as a community activist, I try to say something, especially for the guardian of the, you know, the young generation, because as a guardian, we have a big role in the society. We have a lot of problems in the society for the young boys they are facing at this moment, especially drug, crime, these gang issues, especially in the East London area where we live, in Tower Hamlets or other part. So if is our young generation, they are involved with this crime, how can we have a better generation? For a better generation, যেটা আমি গার্জেনদের জন্য বাংলাতে বলবো, আমাদের গার্জেন হিসাবে আমাদের একটা নৈতিক দায়িত্ব হলো আমাদের ছেলেমেয়েদেরকে ভালো একটা রাস্তা দেখানো। অবশ্যই তারা ভালো একটা স্কুলে যাবে, ইউনিভার্সিটিতে যাবে, সাথে সাথে তাদেরকে হবি হিসাবে একটা কাজ আমাদের দেওয়া উচিত যেটাতে তারা ইনভলভ হবে। তখন তারা অন্য কিছু বাদ জিনিস করার চিন্তা ভাবনা করবে না, ওই সময়টা পাবে না। যদি একটা ছেলে একটা আর্টের জন্য বসে বা কিছু ড্র করতে বসে, ওই আমার হাসান ভাই যেটা বললেন, ওনার মধ্যরাতেও সেটা চিন্তা হয়। তাহলে একটা জিনিস চিন্তা করলে কিন্তু অসংখ্য সময় অনেক সময় চলে যায়, হ্যাঁ, এবং ওর থেকে কিন্তু তার অন্য কোনো বাজে চিন্তা করার কোনো সম্ভাবনা থাকে না। আমি আরেকটু ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ডে যদি যাই, যে আমরা এই যে দেশে আসছি, স্পেশালি ইন ইউকে, স্পেশালি দিস আর্ট অ্যান্ড কালচার, দে হ্যাভ এ লট অফ প্রায়োরিটিজ ইন দিস কান্ট্রি, ইজন্ট ইট? ইভেন ফ্রম দ্য স্কুল, আই গট লিটল কিডস ফ্রম দ্য, ইউ নো, দ্য নার্সারি, দে ট্রাই টু স্টার্ট ড্র সামথিং বাই দ্যাম, ইজন্ট ইট? দিস ইজ এ গুড অ্যাডভান্টেজ ফর আস, হ্যাঁ। এই ছেলেরা কিন্তু জানে, এদেশে কিন্তু প্রত্যেকটা ছেলেমেয়ে আর্ট করা জানে, আমাদের বেকুম বাংলাদেশ বা সাব কন্টিনেন্টের মতো না, এখানে কিন্তু প্রত্যেকটা ছেলেদেরকে মাস্ট আর্ট করতে হয় স্কুলে গেলে। অতএব তাদের হাতে কলমে শিক্ষাটা কিন্তু স্কুল থেকেই তারা পেয়ে যাচ্ছে। এখন যা করতে হবে আমাদের প্যারেন্টস হিসাবে, তাদেরকে এ কাজে আমাদেরকে মোটিভেট করতে হবে, এবং মোটিভেট যদি আমরা করতে পারি তাহলে এখান থেকে আমাদের ভালো ভালো আর্টিস্ট চলে আসবে, এবং এমন কোনো আর্ট হবে যেমন ওই আপনার লিওনার্দো দা ভিঞ্চির মোনালিসা, এটা যুগ যুগ ধরে শত শত বছর ধরে বেঁচে আছে এবং বেঁচে থাকবে, ঠিক না? তো এমন হয়তো আর্টিস্ট আমাদের আমাদের কমিউনিটি থেকে, আমাদের জেনারেশন থেকে চলে আসতে পারে, উই নেভার নো, এবং হয়তো বা তার আর্টটা আজকে হয়তো মূল্যায়িত না হতে পারে, কিন্তু হয়তো আজ থেকে 30-40-50 বছর পরে সেটা মূল্যায়িত হবে। ভালো জিনিস সবসময় ভালো হয়। যেটা আমার ভাই একটা সুন্দর একটা ক্যালিওগ্রাফি বললেন, যে আল্লাহ উত্তম কাজকে সবসময় উত্তম যা যাক দেন, ঠিক না, উত্তম প্রতিদান দেন, তার কাজটা যদি ভালো হয় আজকে না হলে 40-50 বছর পরে সে মূল্যায়িত হবে। আমি আমি এই জন্য একজন আমি আমাদের প্যারেন্টসদেরকে বলবো, আপনারা আপনাদের ছেলেমেয়েদের ইয়াং জেনারেশন থেকে উৎসাহিত করুন, তাদেরকে সময় দিন, তাদেরকে সুযোগ করে দিন আরেকটা জিনিস যেটা আমরা করতে পারি কমিউনিটি ওয়ার্কার হিসেবে আমরা এই এরিয়া বেসিসে আমরা কম্পিটিশনের আয়োজন করতে পারি বা এক্সিবিশনের আয়োজন করতে পারি যেটা আমার জানা মতে আমাদের ইসাক ভাই জড়িত আছেন আমি কিছুতে জড়িত আছি আমরা কিছু মসজিদ কেন্দ্রিক এক্সিবিশন করে থাকি এবং এই এক্সিবিশনগুলোতে অনেক কালচার এবং বিশেষ করে ক্যালিওগ্রাফি এবং ক্রিয়েটিভিটি আমরা তুলে ধরার চেষ্টা করে থাকি তো আমরা প্রত্যেক মাস দুই মাস পরে পরে লোকাল মসজিদগুলোতে চেষ্টা করি আপনার এক্সিবিশনের জন্য যারা কমিউনিটি লোকাল বেসিসে কাজ করে আমি তাদেরকে বলবো আপনাদের বিশেষ করে আপনারা এই যে এখন একটা ভালো একটা সময় যাচ্ছে স্কুল হলিডে পিরিয়ড আপনারা লোকাল ছেলে মেয়েদের জন্য কিছু একটা অ্যাক্টিভিটি করুন তাদেরকে একটা কাজ দিন এবং তাদেরকে উৎসাহিত করুন এবং ওইখানে যে সময় আপনারা কম্পিটিশন করবেন ভালো একজন আর্টিস্ট নিয়ে আসেন অ্যাজ ফর এক্সাম্পল এজ এ রোল মডেল তখন ওই আর্টিস্ট যদি কিছু বলে বা তার কিছু ওয়ার্ক দেখে তারা উৎসাহিত হবে এবং তারা এ কাজে আরও ঝাঁপিয়ে পড়বে তো অ্যাজ এ প্যারেন্টস অ্যান্ড গার্জিয়ান অ্যান্ড অ্যাজ এ কমিউনিটি ওয়ার্কার ফর দ্য ফিউচার অফ আওয়ার কমিউনিটি উই হ্যাভ টু ডু সামথিং ফর দ্যাম
Chamatkar, that's brilliant message.
Thank you.
I know you've been to an exhibition, that's where I met you actually. If you could say, you know, what you saw and your feelings, you've been very interesting for our viewers to know.
Okay, so I went to the April exhibition at the London Muslim Centre, and it was my first, after reading the Quran, it was my, and I was sat next to someone who was Muslim, so I wasn't entirely clueless, but other than that, I had absolutely no experience. And again, I don't know what I was expecting to see, but it was, I loved the colour. I mean, the colours that you pick were the colours that were there, those blues, those pinks, those purples. And I think what I was struck with was the range, the spread, the reach of the culture. So I was expecting the text, I was expecting the faith, but not so much about perfume. That was the one that really struck me.
Wow.
And
last one we had a bigger one. I don't know if you didn't come last one.
But I do have a criticism, which is that you talked about the perfume and there was nothing to smell.
Oh, right.
And the food was custard creams. And I thought you've got this unbelievably rich culture that is really embodied. You know, you have a culture of food, you have a culture of art, you have a culture of smell. And you use paper, one dimension. To demonstrate the culture, there's so much more. Custard creams with your cultural heritage.
You should take on it.
That is dreadful.
I think you know why. I think the exhibition itself is successful. Like the way you made the comment about it. You know, I think we need to.
It is getting look that, into that everything stuff. Engaged, but get some perfumes out there.
Next time I would request you, so we make sure Sue gets proper food, not just custard.
Yeah, well, you're in East London as well. I mean, custard creams.
We only have 5 more minutes. Oh, so I just want to hear just your poem in 2 minutes.
Basically, I forgot my poems. I wrote lots of poems. I cannot remember it at this moment. But I'd like to recite one Bengali poem from our great poet, Shamsur Rahman.
So look into that camera and say it. Yeah.
Okay. Bangla bhasha uccharito hole. চোখে ভেসে ওঠে কত চেনা ছবি মা আমার দোলনা দুলিয়ে কাটছেন ঘুম পাড়ানির ছড়া কোন সে সুদূরে সত্তা তার আশা বড়ি নানি বিষাদ সিন্ধুর স্পন্দনে দুলে দুলে রমজানি সাজে ভাজেন ডালের বড়া আর একুশের প্রথম প্রভাত ফেরি বাংলা ভাষা উচ্চারিত হলে চোখে ভেসে ওঠে কত চেনা ছবি বাংলা ভাষা উচ্চারিত হলে অন্ধ বাউলের একতারা বাজে উদার গৈরিক মাঠে খোলা পথে উত্তাল নদীর বাঁকে বাঁকে নদীও তখন নর্তকী হয় বাংলা ভাষা উচ্চারিত হলে চোখে ভেসে ওঠে কত চেনা ছবি কত চেনা ছবি কত চেনা ছবি
Chamatkar. I mean, hatre ditam kintu dipo na
ki. Thank you.
Chamatkar. Dear viewers, I'm sure you enjoyed it. You know, for me, they made it easy for me. You know, I want to thank you all for, you know, today making time for us. Honestly, I really, really enjoyed it. And I want to do that again, actually. Because it's so rich. We can't go that far. I mean, we started just the beginning. And I picked up a lot of things from that pictures you guys showing me, especially your Fajr one. The thoughts behind it, subhanAllah, the sun rising, the color, this, that, all these things, it's like printing in your head and your mind and in your soul. There's no other way you can go that deep.
True.
You know, if you want to go deep in your religion or anything, you know, we need to see a bigger picture. And I think we are also diverted our attention towards saying, look, this is good and this is bad. Whatever is good, pick it up. Exactly. There are millions of people are doing amazing stuff.
Mm. To be honest, I just like to add one thing. They are so good out there. You have no time to look at the bad. Yeah, believe
so
me.
True. Yeah.
It's so, so true. Much goods out there. So yeah. Just consider on this. You have no time for the other stuff.
No, so just be on yourself.
Exactly.
No, no, definitely. That's definitely. And speak your what you have. You yeah. can be wrong, you
Express
can be right. There
yourself.
Is no wrong and right in exactly. a lot of things. So always we'll have issues that we don't, you know, we don't agree on it. That's normal. That's mm-hmm. how we are. But when it comes to art, you know, we need to see a light where we're going. Mm-hmm. We need to take that lead. The golden age we're talking about, it was, you know, thousands of years ago almost, like, you know, like we mm-hmm. forgot about it.
We need to focus on now, what we can do. This is, time is now in our hand, and we have to spend it with a creative way. Mm-hmm. That's the thing. So, yeah, we hope that every one of us, that the viewers are, you know, getting the true and passionate message from us. And thank you very much, IQRA TV. Yeah.
One thing I do, and we have just 2 minutes left, one thing I always do in our show, because at Youth Hour, we try to encourage young people to say, mm. you know, we say about our parents, we love our parents. You know, we like to say, I challenge everybody when they come in the camera to say, I love my mom or I love my dad. So yeah. if I start with some guy, which can I start with you? Say something to your mom, say, I love you or something like that.
Ma, assalamu alaikum, tomake onek bhalobashi.
Mashallah. And dad, definitely. Hassan bhai.
If I was to say something to my mom, I would say one thing. When I had my first child, at that day, in the labor room, I learned what mom is, and all I'll say, I love you.
Thank you. Naid bhai, I know it's yeah. a bit
sorry, I've lost my mom in 2008. Just oh. say, sorry, I'm missing my mom a lot.
Mm. So, would you like to say anything?
I lost my dad last summer, so I'm missing him a lot. But, mom, your pastry isn't as good as mine. Sorry.
She's being honest, hopefully. Same thing to my mom as well. I love you. And then our young brothers and sisters, look, we have parents. We need to, you know, show them our respect and gratitude. Sometimes it's too late. They're gone and we become lonely and say, I wish they were here and I wish they were there and all that stuff. Sometimes it's too late. Mm-hmm. And for our parents, especially our young people, they are our future. They are part of our heart. It's like we're breathing them. Mm-hmm. And then it's almost like if we don't guide them, you know, we don't want to be sensitive. If we don't guide them rightly and give them freedom to choose as well. Sometimes what we're doing is you do that, you become a doctor, you become this and that, but sometimes it doesn't work, but the person doesn't mm-hmm. want this to happen. Mm-hmm. Be honest with them.
Exactly.
When I was young, what did I think about it? I always said, oh, why is my mom telling me what to do and brother's telling me what to do? What can I do about myself? So same thing now, it's our turn for the test. So I hope we learned something today and hope to see you next week, inshallah. If we said anything wrong, please do forgive us and from our guest. And please, please, please make dua for every one of us and see you next week, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.